里我们希望借由这标题让观众可以很直觉就往科学面去做联想。这个展览其实特别想要强调的是观众对这个世界的好奇心。
这件作品它上面这黑色的材质，它是导电碳末。如果说我们的想法都是一些电流的话，就那这些电流如果可以传递的时候，是不是就等于把我的想法啊跟外界做连接？这样子的状态我觉得很棒。
And also we like when we mix magic with plastic art, but people they feel magic sensation, but they don't feel a trick of magic.
Really interested about the little poesies, little poetry. We hope that the visitors could see that and say, oh, right, maybe this Sunday I will try. You know, the magic is it's not magic.
Title of Nahurawa Center is a botanical garden.These objects is connected together and all together, and then I imagine about like an artificial environment for the space. But people can notice it's like animals, like trees. It's really good thing.
Bubbles are very strange objects. They don't behave like other things in the world. They don't fall down on the floor, but they float, and so they seem to be special objects. You can, again, experience this emotion of wonder when you see a really huge bubble. This project, I was living in Beijing, and I would see people doing water calligraphy, shufa. It was such a beautiful,idea. I'd never seen this before, and I thought it was so interesting to try and use water as a material for writing on the ground.
I'm very, very happy that we made it possible to use this kind of canvas, because I normally make new works for new exhibitions, so it's every time it's a site-specific arrangement or adaptation.And this is actually the first time I managed to get a nice material from the country I'm exhibiting in.
观众其实会在一个全黑的环境里面看到，这个光在空间里面飞行。
这一颗灯球它是由三条线接着，这三条线它上面有通讯号跟电的可能。我们把郝广宗的一些精神跟手法都藏在天花板里面。
你在进入展场的时候，你看到是色块的呈现，但是你感觉不到它的体积。它表现出来的也是像一个路线图 ,3D 的路线图一样。你可以想象怎么样人在这个结构里面穿越、行走、围绕。在车厢移动的空间中，我们抓住铁柱的时候，我们所遗留下的痕迹，它这个温度怎么样延续或者是断裂，其实是我比较感兴趣的一个状态。
嘴巴仙这件作品是源自于中国武术的一个概念。 所以你可以看到他作品里面有很多软性的动作，但其实他要讲的是非常刚性的内在的语汇。我用一种仿生学的概念呈现出自然界里的生命跟我们人类所产生出来的一个非常简单的对话的行为。
时光它其实用90个日光灯，就是我们跟作品近一点的时候可以听到日光灯它自己发出来的很清脆的声音。另外一件作品是 LAP， 它就是用雷射跟日光灯去共组一段三分钟左右的音乐，是我会用一种麦克风把日光灯的杂音把它放大。那个的经验也会很特殊，因为它跟光的连接是非常非常的类比，跟非常的同步的。
那不论你是从事科学或是你是艺术家，那其实你如果保有对世界的好奇，这个世界会因为你的观点产生更多彩多姿的风貌。